Hi, this is Nasato375. I'm going to start a new series here. I'm going to call it The Shaper is Back, in honor of the excellent video series that began about a year and a half, maybe even 2 years ago, on the axe and how it had been mostly replaced by big survival blades for chopping and splitting wood and carving and everything. The axes were always there, but they had more or less fallen from favor, and a lot of people were talking them down in videos and criticizing the weight and so forth. But they've come back now, and that series started, The Axe is Back, and I watched a lot of those, and it was just really enjoyable. So in honor of that, I'm calling this first in a series, The Shaper is Back. And I'd like to see people make a response or make a shaper video and, you know, continue the name, The Shaper is Back, and show their shaper in operation with a pet project, or hopefully their maybe even their first project that they've done on it. That's what I have set up in mind now, this vise here, this Chinese-made vise I'm trying to true up. So make a video, show your shaper, and get it up. I'd love to see more videos on shapers. There are some on YouTube, quite a few now, but they're not really that organized for the most part, and I'd like to see some organization and a little more talking and information passed on to the community. So, the shaper in past years was, as a lot of people know, was replaced by mostly the vertical milling machine, I think, and you know, the vertical mill is faster, and the shaper just fell from favor, and they were all sold off. I guess a lot of them are probably scrapped. But like the axe, in recent years it's made a comeback, and I'm watching the price on these things on Craigslist and in other places go up, because people are like rediscovering how useful they are for a small shop or a garage shop or a hobby type environment. They're just excellent for home use. And there's the South Bend, the Amco, the Atlas. They're all in the 7 to 8 inch range, and it's a pretty useful machine. And if you haven't seen the excellent video by Rudy Kuhup, How to Operate a Shaper, I believe it's called, it's just really great. He's got a really old one he restored, and he passes on a wealth of information in that video. But anyway, this is my Atlas 7B, made by Atlas for Craftsman. It's badged Craftsman. And I have the vise set up. As you notice, the ram is going back and forth, but it's not feeding. So I'm going to turn on the feed here, and we'll start this cut. I dialed in 5 thousandths from where I just touched the edge, and then I moved the table over, and I'm going to start taking a cut now. So let's see if we can get it going. And there it goes. Now you can make the ram go faster. I have it set on the slowest speed because I don't mind. I'm in what's the rush? And I want to get a nice finish, and I want to be able to control things, and I can keep up with a machine like this. If you turn the speed up, it goes back and forth so fast that it's hard to do much or to keep up with it. And if you want to do your compound for vertical cuts, or well, not your compound, your vertical slide. Looks like a compound on a lathe, doesn't it? If you want to do your vertical slide, either feeding in an up direction or a down direction, you have to be going slow enough so that at the back of the stroke here, you can make the adjustment, like right here. Then it'll take the next cut. So as you can probably hear that. I'm sure you can hear that. We're taking about a 4 or 5 thousandths cut. Now I don't know if it's going to be cleaning up over here, but if it's not, I'll just take another one. Because the idea here is to get a flat, smooth surface on this thing. I haven't really done any work on this shaper other than trying to clean the inside and make sure everything is oiled, and I adjusted the ram travel and the ram position, which seemed to help a lot, make things go more smoothly. But other than truing the table up, taking this cut here, I cut the whole table, and the shaper, I believe, is the only machine that can really do that. At least I was told that. It can true its own table. And I believe I saw in the literature somewhere by Atlas that periodically everybody, you know, should take a truing cut. And of course, this machine has had many years of use, even though it's still in good shape. It's had a lot of use, and a table was really getting beat up, so I decided to true it up and see if that helps. Because when I first machined or shaped, I don't know what you call it, the top of this, the bottom of this vise here, it's only within about 3/1000ths over the total surface. So I'm hoping it'll come out a lot better now. Now you can hear the interrupted cut it's taking now, because it's going over the slots. Okay, this is not an axis back video, but I've noticed in the axis back video, there's a lot of, in a wooded environment, usually with a campfire, they're usually making about a pound or two of bacon, and they're commenting that they're gonna eat the whole darn thing. Well, I don't have any bacon, but keeping up the same idea and the tradition, I made a breakfast in the kitchen so I could bring it out into my man cave. So I'm not in the woods, I'm not in the outdoors, but I'm kind of in a manly place here. So I've got to chug down some sausage and eggs and cheese and potato and I've even got a ear of corn on the cob here that I made in the microwave. Yeah, comes out really good in the microwave. Comes out really well. So let's zoom in here so you can get a better. And I apologize for not getting in there more quickly. Actually, I meant to zoom in right after I started the cut. Let's see if we can rotate this thing. There we go. And I think we can even get in closer. Let's see. Yeah, there it is. You know how close you can go in and have this thing still focus. And you can see the chips. It's taking a fine cut. Like I said, no more than 5/1000ths. And the finish is, be careful when you're doing this. Not bad. The tool bit came with the shaper, and I've been using this. Well, I used it to true the table up. I used it to take the first four or five cuts off the bottom of the vise, light cuts to be sure, but I still took a lot of cuts. And I haven't sharpened it yet. It's carbide, and I think it is a cast iron bit, which is good, because that's what I'm cutting here. Okay, so what about, well, you know, I don't have the bacon, but this is a man cave, and let's see, what time is it? It's afternoon, it's 1 o'clock, and I haven't had breakfast yet, so this is kind of a brunch. Let's go back here a little. Got my corn on the cob here. Let's see here. Oh man, wow. Oh. You know, something I've never tried to cook corn on a grill or over a campfire. But I saw Suebo 6 do it one time, and according to him, you know, it's a pretty good idea. It tastes pretty good. So, and there's sausage and an omelet I made with a little cheese on top that I added later, some tomatoes and some raw green onions. The omelet has ham, chopped up ham fine, and chopped up green onions that are more or less cooked inside of it. And these are over here are raw. So this is a pretty good late breakfast. So let's see here. Oh, that's a big piece. I'm not going to eat this whole thing. I think I'll save a little bit. It's a 3-egg omelet, although it looks much bigger. Oh, wow. Got to get some sausage here, too. Little tomatoes. Little bit of tomatoes there. Oh, I put the tomatoes after I cut them. I put them on a plate and put them in the refrigerator for about 5 minutes. Then I wait, and then I cook everything up and it's all done at the same time. The tomatoes are cold and... Oh, wait a minute. Oh, oh my gosh. Oh. I love green onions, and I love cooking with them too, you know, chopped up or whatever, diced. Man, hello, Josie. Little shout out there to Bushcraft Barton. She likes to cook with onions too. She did a pancit dish in one of their videos. So that thing's cutting away over there. Oh, oh my God. Well, it's still wet too. I like that inside. It's just a little wet inside. It's not overcooked. And oh man. Oh wow. Well, I'm up to 10 minutes and 50 seconds. So, I read something somewhere that these Atlas, I keep going over to the dryer to get another plate. I have a bowl, the plate for the corn. The bowl has the potato in it. When I cook a chicken, I'll usually get a chicken leg quarter. And oh, I'll get two of them. I'll put them in a big chicken skillet, you know, covered. I won't add any water, but I'll wash small russet potatoes and scrub them real well. And then I'll put them in there whole with the skin on them. And I'll put them in there and I'll start the chicken and the potatoes at the same time. I'll maybe lay some onions on top a little bit. And I won't really use any seasoning, no pepper or seasoning, except for I really salt the chicken like crazy. I put a lot of salt on it, and I saw Christopher Walken do that in a cooking video, no kidding, and he said a lot of salt. So this last time I tried it, and man does it work. And the chicken's not fried, it doesn't get browned, it just cooks, and the skin is really tender and the juice comes out. And about every 15 minutes you kind of rotate and flip the potatoes over so they get in that juice while they're cooking, and oh my, and here's one of the potatoes. This potato here, I added some of the chicken fat and the juice and everything congeals, because you know it's basically fat. And in the refrigerator, when you're trying to keep it from spoiling for a couple of days, it hardens up and you get like chunks and it's kind of gummy. Not very appetizing sounding, is it? And I'll put that on the potato. Cut the potato that's already cooked, and I'll put it in the microwave, and the chicken fat and juices will melt into the potato. And I added a little butter to this one, but this russet potato, it's a small one, but it's just unbelievable. Oh my God! And I swear it's been in there 3 days, and it seems like it's better than ever. In the fridge, I mean. So we're finishing up the first side on the machine, and I'm going to continue on here, and I guess this will do it for the first in the series. I'm up to 13 minutes and 24 seconds, so Macedo 375 here. I'm signing out for now, and appreciate your views. Appreciate your consideration of making your own The Shaper Is Back video. And I'll be looking forward to hearing from you, and hopefully I'll see some videos. It'd be really nice. Bye for now. I've got to find a button.